you can see the Honoli VOR is 6 nautical miles away. If we multiply that by 3, that gives us 1800. So this aircraft, if it were actually to be landing, would be at 1800 at this point. So I can logically deduce that in a moment, assuming it's on the centre line, that's going to start descending because it's intercepting the ILS from below. So if my logic is correct, that should go down to 1600 in a moment. There we are, 16. So I know that's coming into land. I didn't want to line up and take off because I thought that I might end up talking about something or saying something on the runway, and then that aircraft would go around, which would result in it flying on top of us, and then I'd have to delay my takeoff anyway for that aircraft to get out of the way and go around the circuit again. So I'm probably saving time either way by just waiting here for this aircraft to land. Still can't see it. Oh yes, I do. I have a visual on it. It's just here. Runway's clear, so it should be going around. 737, actually. There it is. Okay, brakes released. Landing lights on. Taxi off. Strobe on. We've got a PAX 3. Turning off to the left. So one quick check. Looking good. I jumped there, sorry. Okay, engine stable, take off power. Oh, one aircraft is going to have to go around because of me on the runway. Don't mind me anymore.
Rewind.
Nope.
Rotate. Redo.
Pitching to 190. Nice 3,000 feet per minute rate of climb. Centre autopilot in command. And VNAV. That go-around traffic's gone off to the right there. Laps 5, gear handle off. Now, if VNAV gets a bit carried away with the speed, we've got climb 1 power come back here, I can simply intervene with vertical speed, which I might do now actually because it's jumping around a bit too much. We'll set a climb at 1800, laps 1. Set 350 here because that's the limit. Very cloudy day. Flaps up. Now we'll be over to departure. What we'll do is tell them that we're passing 3500 on the white gate, I think for Echo. And passing, we're up to 6,000. They will most likely clear us, knowing that we're quite a heavy aircraft, up to around 9,000. And probably keep the speed restriction for the moment. TCAS can go over to TAR right now, rather than just TA. T-59's being held well. Approaching transition altitude. Standard, and if I press B, that gives me the pressure of what's below, but we're actually on standard now. I'll now take this round on heading of, what's that going to be, 328? Traffic in the area is looking okay. I'll end the nav screen, the spot begun. We have climb speed, 330. Got a few extra clearance now up to flight level 150. So no speed restriction. Zoom up to 300 first to let the aircraft settle in a nice climb. Slow the climb a little bit more there. ADS now picked up WHI straight ahead. Turn off the VOR because it's behind us. One aircraft off to our right, 800 below, 900 below, that's okay. Don't have visual knuckle. Now you can see that our climb rate at 1600 feet per minute is giving climb 1 reduction. So if I press flight level change, that will maintain 130 and pitch accordingly to maintain 300 knots. So it's going to pitch down. I'm doing this for demonstration purposes. It's going to pitch down and then it's going to pitch up at 300. That's 3 to 10,000. Turn off our lights there. To go to wing B. Pitch up here. 300 knots. I can give it a little bit of a hand there, as always. Put it to 302. We'll accept climb to flight level 170. And as always, climb 1 in VNAV. Climb 1 will become climb at 15,000. I'm going to level at 17,000, so I'm going to intervene with vertical speed and bring it back down to 2,200. But I'll allow the speed to go up now to 330. That's per the VNAV, 329 now, that's per VNAV recommendation. That lowers as we get lighter. 2,000 to go. And a 50,000 climb up became climb. And I can now reset climb 1 and climb 2 if I wish. Something that can happen with air control with traffic permits, which I might say it does, because most aircraft will aircraft are at least 1,000 feet below me. Is give you a direct routing. Now, Guyper was our point just before Dillon. So ATC could well say direct to Guyper. So when we level at 17,000, that's what I'm going to do. whilst we were on our way to Guyper, I'll switch off the seatbelt signs, continue our climb up to about 25,000 feet. Okay, so I want to level out, we'll climb to flight level 250. We can switch off the ADF and VOR now that they're not talking to us. Okay, leveling out, looks like the vertical speed at 1500 initially on 329. Established, there's no more big turns coming up, and then we're going to be controlling our climb rate. We can turn off the seatbelt because it's now going to be more smooth flying. We've just left this layer of cloud, so the air should be smoother as well. Just push this up to 1800. Traffic's looking good for the next 40 miles. So I'm going to select climb 2, and I'm going to press VNAV. 329 is set, and we're in climb 2, so it's never going to exceed 328, so we've got a nice gentle climb rate, which is exactly what we want. Data, that's going to give us the time of our arrival. When we fly towards, I'm going to intercept the VNAV there with vertical speed just to reduce the rate of climb on level out at flight level 250, just to make it a bit more comfortable for people. Just set that to 5. Nice view. The sun's going to be following us across the Atlantic as we took off in the evening, and we're landing in the evening. So our flight's going to be with the sun. That's why the mid rises. Okay, so we're going to be arriving at 1901 now, and that's important because we need to contact Oceanic Control about 30 to 45 minutes before we actually arrive at the Oceanic Entry Point and West Clearance. ATC don't deal with clearance over the Atlantic, it's done by Shumbuck and Gander.